Hi, I'm Lynn Prowitt for dLifeTV. We are back at Palmer's Market in Darien, Connecticut to talk about Whole Foods shopping. Low carb, low glycemic Whole Foods shopping, that is. In other words, shopping for better blood sugar and better health. Do you ever find yourself looking into other people's shopping carts? I know I do. It's like a little window into their life. Well, what I'm going to show you today is what you would find in my shopping cart on any given week when I'm shopping off of a healthy eating plan. Don't get me wrong, I buy sweets too, but this is what a really good week looks like. And now we have breakfast. So of course for breakfast we have bacon and eggs. But note, the eggs are organic, cage-free, certified humane. And our bacon is nitrate-free, nitrate and nitrite-free, uncured bacon. That's the healthiest way to go. We also have our Greek yogurt, full fat, full of our nice friendly bacteria that we love so much. I'm gonna put in a tablespoon of ground flaxseed to up the fiber and add omega-3s. I also like to put ground flaxseed in oatmeal. Nice rolled oats, old-fashioned slow-cooking oats, best for your blood sugar. Also, mixed berries, the frozen mixed berries. During the season, if you can afford it, get fresh, but all year round, there's always a great selection of frozen berries. They're great to go in your yogurt and in your oatmeal, low-carb, low-glycemic fruit. And last here, I have some ground pork, and this is to make your own homemade breakfast sausage. It's so super easy. Go to dlife.com and look at breakfast sausage recipes. You will see easy as pie and so much better for you than a lot of the commercial brands. And that's breakfast. All right, so now we are looking at lunch and snack foods. So what's in my cart this week? One of my favorite mainstream crackers is Triscuits. The ingredients on Triscuits, very simple. Whole grain, soft white winter wheat, oil and salt. That's a great product. It's a whole wheat, and most people don't even realize that. So we're gonna have crackers and cheese, your basic favorite snack. I love Baby Bell cheese. They're fun to open, delicious little snacks. Of course, you gotta have your cheese sticks, your mozzarella string cheese. Kids love them and adults love them, fun to eat. We're going to have some deli cold cuts, but I warn you about the sodium and the nitrates and nitrites in lunch meats. Whenever you can, if you can afford it, buy organic, buy all natural nitrate and nitrite free. What else we have? We have some cottage cheese, which I like just on crackers. Almonds, nuts are probably next to hard-boiled eggs, my very, very most favorite snackable. We have tuna and salmon, canned tuna and salmon. So the great thing about tuna and salmon are the ease and the shelf life. But also, I bet you didn't know, canned salmon is always wild. It's hard to find wild salmon, it's really expensive. But if you buy it in a can, it's always wild, which is much better for you than the farm-raised. So what I do actually is mix them. I mix salmon and tuna together with mayonnaise, and nobody in my house knows the difference, and they're happy and healthier. I also have frozen edamame, another sort of superfood snackable. You know about soybeans, complete protein, so delicious. Kids love to pop them out of the pod right into their mouth with a little salt. I also have tortillas, low-carb tortillas. They're small, they're low-carb. You can cut them in half, cut the carbs down even further. I melt cheese on them. I put peanut butter on them. For lunch, some veggies, some sauteed mushrooms, and some shredded cheese, little quesadilla. And that is it for lunch. So these are the vegetables in my cart. You'll notice the first group here are salad vegetables. So every night you want to have a salad with your dinner, right? And sometimes you're going to have salad for lunch. So I have lettuce, some nice green leaf, red leaf lettuce, some cucumbers, some tomatoes, and some carrots. The basics for the beginning of a salad, which really I'm gonna have every day. I have some zucchini. I'm gonna saute this zucchini and some garlic and some butter. I might chop up some mushrooms and add it to the zucchini for a side dish. I have some greens and some kale. I'm going to saute them again with garlic and olive oil if I'm in a big rush. And any leftover, I'm gonna chop up and throw in some soup. What else do I have? I have broccoli, the old standby. One way I dress up broccoli is just to cook it, saute it with some olive oil, and then throw some grated Parmesan on top. We also have my favorite three A's vegetables: artichoke, asparagus, and avocado. The three A vegetables are all amazingly high in fiber, high in all nutrients, and avocado is actually really high in fiber and has those great monounsaturated fats that are so good for your heart. So here's what's for dinner this week. First, I'm going to saute some frozen shrimp. I also like to use frozen bay scallops. I'm gonna saute them in some butter and garlic, toss them with pesto sauce, and toss the whole thing at the end with some low-carb pasta. Great dinner. Next, I've got chicken here. I'm gonna make a really simple sauteed chicken with lemon and capers. I'm going to have flank steak one night on the grill in a nice soy ginger marinade. We're gonna have fresh fish one night, also on the grill. I love to have salmon once a week, especially wild salmon, if you can find it. It's much better for you than the farm-raised. And then with my dinners, I'm going to have either a very small quarter cup cooked portion of barley or quinoa. Nice protein alternative also. Those are my dinners this week. Keep this plate graphic in mind for meal planning and for your overall approach to daily eating. Also, remember to spread your carbs throughout the day. Choose high fiber carb foods and always pair them with protein. Keep healthy by eating a good variety of unprocessed animal and plant foods. And think color. Eat a rainbow assortment of fiber-rich veggies and fruits. To find the healthy eating plate and for more information on healthy eating with diabetes, go to dlife.com/eatingright. I'm Lynn Prowitt for dLife TV. Thanks for watching.
That's the show for today. Thanks for tuning in. I know I learned a lot, and I want to know what you think. So be sure to share your thoughts in the comments below, and I'll see you here next Sunday, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, for another exciting episode of dLife TV Online.